welcome you aboard. And then we usually go up to 57th Street, go across 57th, and then back down. But I'll try to give you an idea of what's going on and where we are and so on. Just a week ago today, that building ahead of you with the rounded corners and the rounded windows, to the left you can see an elevator shaft there. Just 1 week ago, that elevator shaft fell down, most of it, had the accident. It was an area with a lot of sort of gang warfare, Irish-American gangs, and a lot of saloons in the area. It's much quieter now than it used to be. 100 to 300 are called off-Broadway theaters. Less than that are called off-Broadway. Let's head up into the sky there. That's a statue of Christopher Columbus. And to and from which all distances in New York City are measured. So if you live 3,000 miles away from New York City, you live 3,000 miles away from that statue right up there. To the right. It's closed for the summer. They'll be back in the fall. Campaign to make its way to New York City. We now have the Planet Hollywood, Motown, and Harley-Davidson cafes, plus the Zeppelin High cafe, not far ahead of us. They are ranging along 57th Street and 6th Avenue. With the, probably the best acoustics of any music hall in the United States, and perhaps in the world. First stop is here at the Park Central. Crummy sandwiches. I have no preference, but if you want to make a taste test, bring along a big appetite, because their sandwiches are 2.5 inches thick. Dinner where cats has been playing for a very long time. It's the longest running musical in American history on Broadway. At the other end of Times Square, light pole with a dark blue flag at the top of it there, is the building is number one Times Square. That flag pole is the pole down which a big ball in the shape of a red apple drops on New Year's Eve. When it hits the bottom of the flag pole, that was usually a crowd of 250 to 300,000 people. When we are moving, please stay seated, because you'll notice as we go along, some of these traffic lights are very low. This one is not is higher than some of them. Some of them are very low and just clear the top of the bus.
So I want you to go down and see, according to Times Square, if that means anything to you.
To our right is the Paramount building. There used to be a theater, the Paramount Theater, movie house down here on the right where it says RAG. And that is where all the big bands used to play. Glenn Miller's orchestra, Tommy Dorsey, where it says RAG. And at that time, whenever Sinatra finished singing, there was always a crowd of so-called bobby socks, or teenage girls, who surrounded him and squealed and screamed and made a general, I started to say nuisance of themselves, but that wasn't it. There was always a crowd of teenagers screaming when Frank Sinatra used to sing right there.
I'm looking.
Yeah.
You'll see part of Times Square is still closed off here off to the left.
Your name is in the night.
stories tall. Built in 1929 and 1930. It was the tallest building in the world from the time it was finished until the World Trade Center Twin Towers were built in 1916.
Building with the points on it.
Down Broadway from Central Park down to which is just ahead. And the other event is the 4th of July fireworks.
Mama, look here. Courtney, please sit down.
The area we will be passing through next, as we cross Broadway and 6th Avenue, is called Herald Square. The Empire State over to Madison Square Garden. This is the area for shopping, for clothing. A lot of discount stores along here. About three quarters of the way up the Empire State Building on a foggy day during World War II, an American bomber crashed into that building. It killed the bomber crew and several people in the building itself. There is, of course, an observation platform. At night, they have the top of the building lighted, and the color of the lights is changed very frequently. On the 4th of July, they have red, white, and blue lights. On Halloween, they have orange lights. On St. Patrick's Day, they have green lights. And they keep changing all during the year. But they turn those lights off at two times during the year. New York City happens to lose their direction. As I say, it's called the Empire State Building, but for many years after it was built, it was called the Empty State Building because there were so few tenants. As I say, it was built in 1930, and for the next few years after that, it was the middle of the Depression, and there weren't many people with money enough to rent office space in a prestigious building like this. But the occupancy rate now is fairly high. This scaffolding here has been here now for about a year and a half. They're still working on the side of the building. There is a stop here. We're not quite there yet. And this is the stop for the Empire State Building. The next stop after this will be at 5th Avenue and 14th Street. And after that, we go down into Hill, close to the Astor family, and Waldorf, or the town in Germany from which the Astor family originally came. The present-day Waldorf Astoria is up on Park Avenue between 49th and 50th Street. Madison Square Garden.
Where?
Now there's always a breeze here at this corner that we're coming up to, 5th Avenue and 23rd Street. And when this Flatiron building was first built, it's so narrow that many of the people of that time were afraid to go above the 10th floor. They thought the wind might blow the building over. Well, that hasn't happened. The building was built in 1903, and it looks like it's going to last for another 100 years after that. Radio TV stations. Tower has the distinction about having the world's highest outdoor observation platform, 110 stories up in the sky. That was the tallest building in the world until the Sears Tower in Chicago came along. Does anybody know where the tallest building in the world is now? Up the state of New York, towards the Canadian border. In one form or another, it's still Broadway. By Frank W. Woolworth in 1913. For 25 years, that was the tallest building in the world, until the Chrysler Building came along in 1938. City Hall of New York and the city. Now you're going to see yourself in the mirror here as we turn the corner here. Just look up and there you are. Ahead of us on the other side of that street are called the World Financial Center. One of them is that first building is the headquarters of American Express, the worldwide headquarters. Just behind it, next to the river, is the Mercantile Exchange. This is West Street we're crossing or we're going to be on. West Street is so called because this was the World Trade Center. Now you remember perhaps in 1993 that a rental car filled with a rental truck explosives was parked in the garage underneath the Twin Towers here. And over where you see the Bell Atlantic panel truck over there, about 20 feet below that is where the truck filled with explosives was set off by remote control. It knocked out 8 of the 12 sub-bases, but it knocked out light and power to the whole building. And just that is the stop where you will get off for the boats for the Statue of Liberty and Ellis Island and for the Staten Island Ferry. Off to the left, when they had control of the city, and then that is also in 1776, that is where the Declaration of Independence was read to the people of New York City.
Oh, really?
At that time, there was a statue of King George III in the park, and after the Declaration of Independence was read, some patriots pulled down the statue. Building direct boat, the Statue of Liberty, Ellis Island. And to get there, you go along this sidewalk right here that you see where that crowd of people is. And you go right out across the park.
Well, save some for the front office. Well, save some for the front office.
Why would you need a wide window?
Thank you. la piano facciamo tutto insieme. La stessa data.
Yeah. Thank you. una de las fuentes que une con aquellos nuevos.
Thank you.
Yeah. last bus of the day. And then the Lower East Side, then the East Village, and the United Nations. And then we're back into the heart of Midtown. To Washington, this is where the first inaugural speech was given in 1789, presidential inaugural speech. On the left, you've got Trinity Church, one of the oldest churches in town, and one of the ones you're into finance. And Morgan Sr. actually lived in this building for a while.
Yes, we do. Yes.
This is our stop here. Who was the first Secretary of the Treasury for the United States? He was one of the first students at Columbia University, which was started back behind us. So J.P. Morgan was one of the... Are they enclosed tennis courts? Built on old shipping piers. Pier 7. The South Street Seaport Museum.
Along the East River, about 600 acres.
They 1993, we had about 2,000 headquarters here. It's been here, it was opened in 1952. It took 6 years to build the headquarters. The charter for the United Nations was signed in San Francisco in 1946, and then they began construction on the headquarters here. In the meantime, delegates had already moved to New York, and they were housed and they worked in a conference hall and out in Flushing Meadows Park in Queens on the site of the 1939 World's Fair. And it didn't seem to be an appealing view, so they developed here about 20 years later. Here's our thank you. Times Square. Okay. Times Square, exit through the back of the bus, folks.